this was a grocery shopping haul, and I had bought two of these Home Chef meal kits. One was an almond-crusted chicken, and the other was a salmon tortilla one. Both scrumptious, and I highly recommend them to you. This one, I have never tried the beef Home Chef before, so I'm going to be attempting to prepare the Cajun steak strips and peppers. And it has cheddar, parmesan, polenta also. So I'll be attempting to prepare those things. I have not pre-cut or diced or opened anything yet. So there will be lapses in the video where I won't be talking. I'll just be chopping and dicing and cutting and slicing and dicing. But I'd like to show you what's in the box first. Milk and sulfites, and Cajun seasoning. And there you have it. So we'll put this box aside. As you can tell already, I will be whispering in this video. You'll be seeing a lot of my back because I'll be cutting and preparing the food. I'm going to set the timer for 15 minutes because that is what it said on the recipe card. Oh, by the way, they all come with recipe cards, all right? And it says that the preparation time is 15 minutes, the prep and cook. And how many servings? It's easy level. And the spice level is medium, which is right up my alley. I don't like things too spicy, so sorry if you can't see my face. I'm gonna go right into it. I might leave out some of the directions, but there are four steps. First step is stem seed to remove the ribs and cut the red bell pepper into thin strips. Separate the steak strips into a single layer and pat dry. Season all over with Cajun seasoning. So I'll be doing that first, all right? So I won't be talking for a little bit. To set the timer. 15 minutes. These are thin enough, the strips. using this skillet. It's a non-stick skillet. And I'll be using this small pot for the polenta. Place a large nonstick pan over medium-high heat and add 2 teaspoons of olive oil. Add the red bell pepper to a hot pan and cook undisturbed until starting to soften about 2 to 3 minutes. So I need 2 teaspoons of olive oil. Process, I may have to place a spatter lid on top and have the fan running, so I hope that's all right for your ears. This is a splatter card. 3 minutes. It says to push the peppers aside and place the steak next to it. Add steak strips to empty side of pan and cook those for about 3 minutes. Now I'm gonna cook the polenta. I need to bring 2 1/4 cups water to a boil. About 3 minutes. Push this aside now, the peppers. I'm going to start adding the meat. One thing I can tell already is that I need a much larger non-stick skillet. Seems to be cooking pretty fast, though. The steak. Well, there goes the 15-minute timer. It's taking a lot longer than that. The meat's still red. But I
piece of pepper in the wrong spot. I hope you find the cooking sounds relaxing. I think I might turn the fan on. Hope you can still hear me. The water for polenta is now boiling. If I seem to be rushing, it's because I'm a little worried that the time to cook is ceasing. Once water is boiling, stir in half the demi-glace. Reserve remaining for steak strips. Pour in polenta in a steady stream. Whisk constantly until incorporated. Season with a 1/4 teaspoon salt. It says remove it from the burner. I don't know if you can see that. Probably not. Remove from burner and stir in Parmesan, cheddar cheese, and butter. Cover and set aside. Very cheesy. I don't know if you can see that, but very cheesy. Polenta. Check. cheddar and parmesan and butter. I didn't get all the lumps out because I think you need to whisk faster when you're pouring it in a steady stream, the polenta in. Live and learn. Now, back to the beef. Stir in remaining demi-glace and 2 tablespoons water and bring to a simmer. Garbage. I don't know if you're counting, but this is taking a lot more than 15 minutes. Rinse time. Tablespoons of water. And it says simmer. Turn it over. Rotate the pieces of meat in the demi-glace. Sort of like a sauce, gravy. Coating. And make sure all the meat gets covered in the demi-glace mixture. Coming to the round end of the cooking, it says, so once simmering, stir occasionally until liquid thickens to coat the steak and no pink remains on the meat. About 3 more minutes. And then to finish the dish, if polenta is too stiff, stir in warm water, 1 tablespoon at a time. Plate dish as pictured on front of card, topping polenta with peppers and steak. Bon appetit. So that's what it will look like. So I'll do my best to plate it like that. Have my plate ready to go. didn't take too much, think, of prep time. Well, it wasn't difficult. Let's just say that. I think it does take more than 15 minutes. In all, I want to make sure the pink is gone, so that's important. But in all, it looks ready to go. Looks like the pink is gone. Medium well. I always get my steak medium well. Better to be safe than sorry. I think we're ready to plate. Polenta looks very cheesy. And good. Looks like macaroni and cheese without the macaroni. Turn off all the burners. There you are. There's a wonderful dish ready for eating. Parmesan and cheddar cheese polenta with red pepper strips and Cajun seasoned steak strips. Bon appetit. Thanks for joining me today. And thanks to my subscriber who recommended this good suggestion. Appreciate your viewership. And if you'd like to subscribe down below, if you like the video, please like it. If you want to see more videos from me, Platinum Bliss ASMR. Bye-bye.